Hello. Welcome to the Detroit Experience. I'm an android and I'll be your hostess. Before we begin, let's make some adjustments to optimize your experience. These language settings were detected on your console. Are they correct? Please adjust your screen settings. Thank you. Now select your profile. When this sign is displayed, please do not turn off your console. You are now ready to begin Detroit. Remember, this is not just a story. This is our future.
You can't do that! You...
Why aren't you sending a real person?! Don't let that thing here!
Any second! I don't give a shit! My men are ready to step in, just give the order!
Captain Allen, my name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
It's firing at everything that moves. It already shot down two of my men. We could easily get it, but they're on the edge of the balcony. If it falls, she falls.
Do you know if it's been behaving strangely before this?
I haven't got a clue. Does it matter?
I need information to determine the best approach. Do you know its name?
Listen. Saving that kid is all that matters. So either you deal with this fucking android now, or I'll take care of it.
Units hold positions. Negotiators going in.
closer or I'll jump!
No, please! I'm begging you!
Go!
Hi, Daniel!
How?
My name is Connor!
How do you know my name?
I know a lot of things about you. I've come to get you out of this. She betrayed you, but she's done nothing wrong.
She lied to me! I thought she loved me. But I was wrong. She's just like all the other humans.
Daniel, no!
They were going to replace you, and you became upset. That's what happened, right?
I thought I was part of the family. I thought I mattered. But I was just their toy. Something to throw away when you're done with it.
Listen. I know it's not your fault. These emotions you're feeling are just errors in your software.
No. It's not my fault. I never wanted this. I love them. You know? But I was nothing to them. Just a slave to be ordered around.
He's losing blood. If we don't get him to a hospital, he's going to die.
All humans die eventually. What does it matter if this one dies now?
I'm going to apply a tourniquet.
Don't touch him! Touch him and I'd kill you.
Okay.
I can't stand that noise anymore. Tell that helicopter to get out of here.
The situation is under control.
There. I did what you wanted. You have to trust me, Daniel. Let the hostage go, and I promise you, everything will be fine.
I want everyone to leave! And I want a car. When I'm outside the city, I'll let her go.
That's impossible, Daniel. Let the girl go, and I promise you won't be hurt.
Want to die.
You're not going to die. We're just going to talk. Nothing will happen to you. You have my word.
Okay. I trust you. To me, Connor.
You lied to me.
Thank you.
This is the top-of-the-range household assistant. It cooks 10,000 different dishes.
Come on, Zoe, let's go.
200 languages and dialects. And handles the kids' homework from elementary school up to university level.
Honey, it looks amazing. This is exactly what we need.
How much did you say it cost?
At the moment, we're doing a special promotion on this entire range at $7,999 with a 48 months interest-free credit. And it comes with a 2-year warranty for parts and labor. Painting, plumbing, gardening, repairs. At night, it switches to surveillance mode and contacts emergency services if there's a break-in or if it detects smoke.
Excuse me, how much is that one over there?
The MP800 is slightly more expensive, but it has many other functions. Come along and I'll show you.
I don't like this guy.
There it is. It's a bit difficult getting it back in working order.
Okay.
It was really messed up. What'd you say happened to it again?
The car hit it. Stupid accident.
Ah, I see. Anyway, it's as good as new now, except that we had to reset it, meaning we had to wipe its memory. I hope you don't mind.
It'll be fine.
Okay. Did you give it a name?
My daughter did.
AX400, register your name.
Kara.
My name is Kara.
Would you like to go home now?
Yes, Rose. Yes, I think that's enough for one day.
Here. Let me help.
Thank you. Identification verified. Here is your order number 847. That will be $63.99. Please confirm payment.
Payment confirmed.
Transaction complete.
Coming? You've been gone for 2 weeks, so the place is a mess. You do the housework, the washing, you cook the meals, and you take care of... God damn it, where the fuck's the brat gone now? Alice! Alice! Oh, there you are. That's Alice. You look after her. Homework, bath, all that crap. Got it?
Yes, Todd.
Get started down here, then you do upstairs. Tomorrow. Yeah, same place. You know where. Right. TV on.
Fuck, man.
I've made a good start down here. I'll head upstairs.
Do what you have to do, but stop bothering me. Shit.
I just want to tidy up your room a little. I only need 2 minutes. Is that okay, Alice? I'm sure we used to be friends before I was reset. Maybe we can be friends again. Your father said you chose my name. Kara, it's nice. How did you choose it? You should tell me about yourself. What you like to do, where you like to go, your favorite foods. That would really help me. Okay. I can see you want some space. I'll leave you alone.
you doing?
I'm playing.
You're playing? I know what you're thinking. You think your dad's a lowlife? Huh? Fucking loser? Can't get a job, take care of his family? Don't you think I tried to make things work? But whatever I do, when someone comes along, they just fuck it all up! I know what you think of me. You hate me. You hate me, don't you? Say it! You hate me! God. What am I doing? I'm sorry, honey. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You know I love you, don't you? You know I love you.
Good morning, Carl.
Good morning.
It's 10 a.m. The weather is partly cloudy, 54 degrees, 80% humidity with a strong possibility of afternoon showers.
It sounds like a good day to spend in bed.
I did go to pick up the paint that you ordered.
Oh, yes, I've forgotten. That is the difference between you and me, right, Marcus? You never forget anything.
Show me your arm, please, Carl.
No.
Carl. Thank you.
I just opened my eyes and I'm already gritting my teeth. Humans are such a fragile machine. They break down so quickly. All this effort to keep them going.
Okay. I'll take you to the bathroom now.
Anything special on the agenda today?
Yes, there's the opening of your retrospective at the Museum of Modern Art. Mm. The gallery director left 4 messages asking to confirm your attendance.
I haven't decided yet. We'll see about that later.
Okay.
What else?
Just your usual fan mail. I've already answered.
Any news from Leo?
No, Carl. I can call him if you like.
No. No, don't bother. I'm starving.
Well, your breakfast is ready. Bacon and eggs, just the way you like them.
Thank you, Marcus.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Marcus. Television.
Tensions continue to rise in the Army. Several Russian warships have taken position in the Barents Sea since Saturday, and the Russian flag now flies over the ice. The Russian president.
Why don't you find something to do while I finish my breakfast?
Sure. Okay, Carl.
Fancy game of chess?
Sure, yeah.
Speed chess.
Speed chess it is.
That is a very odd draw.
Well, I know that you don't like to lose, but you don't like it when I let you win either. A draw feels like an honorable compromise, no?
One day I won't be here to take care of you anymore. You'll have to protect yourself and make your choices. Decide who you are and want to become. This world doesn't like those who are different, Marcus. Don't let anyone tell you who you should be. Let's go to the studio. Let's see where we left off. Remove the sheet. So, what's your verdict, Marcus?
Yes, there is something about it. Something I can't quite define. I guess I like it.
The truth is, I have nothing left to say anymore. Each day that goes by brings me closer to the end. I'm just an old man clinging to his brushes.
Carl.
But enough about me. Let's see if you have any talent. Give it a try. Try painting something.
Paint? What would I... Painting what?
Anything you want. Give it a try. That is a perfect copy of reality. But painting is not about replicating the world. It's about interpreting, improving on it, showing something you see.
Carl, I don't think I can do that. It's not in my program.
Go on, go, try it. Grab that canvas. Do something for me. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Trust me. Try to imagine something that doesn't exist, something you've never seen. Now concentrate on how it makes you feel and let your hand drift across the canvas. God.
Hey, Dad.
Leo. I didn't hear you come in.
No, I was in the neighborhood. I thought I'd stop by. It's been a while, right?
You all right? You don't look so good.
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. Hey, listen, I need some cash, Dad.
Again? What happened to the money I just gave you?
It just goes, you know?
Yeah, you're on it again, aren't you?
No, I swear, it's not that.
No, don't lie to me, Leo.
What difference does it make? I just need some cash, that's all.
Sorry. The answer's no.
What? Why?
You know why.
Yeah, I think I do know why. you'd rather take care of your plastic toy here than your own son, right? Tell me, Dad, what's it got that I don't? Smarter, more obedient, not like me, right? But you know what? This thing is not your son. It's a fucking machine!
Leo, that's enough! enough.
You don't care about anything except yourself and your goddamn paintings. You've never loved anyone. You never loved me, Dad. You never loved me.
Lieutenant Anderson, my name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. I looked for you at the station, but nobody knew where you were. They said you were probably having a drink nearby. I was lucky to find you at the fifth bar.
What do you want?
You were assigned a case early this evening. A homicide involving a CyberLife android. In accordance with procedure, the company has allocated a specialized model to assist investigators.
Well, I don't need any assistance. Especially not from a plastic asshole like you. Just be a good little robot and get the fuck out of here.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I must insist. My instructions stipulate that I have to accompany you.
You know where you can stick your instructions?
No. Where?
Never mind.
I understand that some people are not comfortable in the presence of androids, but
I am perfectly comfortable. Now back off before I crush you like an empty beer can.
You know what? I'll buy you one for the road. What do you say? Bartender, the same again, please.
See that, Jim? Wonders of technology. Make it a double. Homicide. Listen, you really have to stop pissing me off if you want to make it through the rest of the night in one piece.
Josh Douglas for Channel 16, can you confirm that this is a homicide?
I'm not confirming anything.
Typical DPD, they don't tell us shit.
Androids are not permitted beyond this point.
It's with me. You don't talk, you don't touch anything, and you stay out of my way. Got it?
Got it. Evening, Hank. We were starting to think you weren't gonna show.
Yeah, that was the plan till this asshole found me.
So, you got yourself an android, huh?
Oh, very funny. Just tell me what happened.
We had a call around 8 from the landlord. The tenant hadn't paid his rent for a few months, so he thought he'd drop by, see what was going on. That's when he found the body. Jesus, that smell. It was even worse before we opened the windows. The victim's name's Carlos Ortiz. He has a record for theft and aggravated assault. According to the neighbors, he was kind of a loner. Stayed inside most of the time. They hardly ever saw him.
Well, state he's in. Wasn't worth calling everybody out in the middle of the night. Could have waited till morning.
I'd say he's been there for a good 3 weeks. We'll know more when the coroner gets here. There's a kitchen knife over here. Probably the murder weapon.
Any sign of a break-in?
Nope. The landlord said the front door was locked from the inside. All the windows were boarded up. The killer must have gone out the back way.
What do we know about his android?
Not much. The neighbors confirmed he had one, but it wasn't here when we arrived. I gotta get some air. Make yourself at home. Oh, my. I'll be outside if you need me.